Right, here we are in Barchem, the town in the area of Lochem. And this forest here is called the Kale Berg. And I just had dinner at the little snack hut over there. So I've already visited a thrift store in Zutphen. Couldn't find anything interesting there. So I decided to go here and have a nice little walk. This is an area where I've never been before. So this is like the first time that I've gone here. And kind of planned this out on Google Maps in advance. So I know there's supposedly some kind of little building in this woods. But yeah, this is the Kale Berg. It's somewhere between Barchem and Borculo and Lochem. And yeah, it's not that far from home. I mean, it's like, well, somewhere between 40 and 50 kilometers from Hengelo. Anyway, previous video I mentioned I was renovating the PC, and they are currently doing that right now. Yep, I ordered the i5 system with the 9600K processor. So if everything goes well, video editing will be going a lot smoother from now on. The only thing I'm a little bit worried about is my Windows 10 installation. I've already transferred it to a larger SSD and updated it to the latest update version. And then of course I had some problem with my Cork MIDI drivers, but that's the least of worries because that's already fixed. It's just a thing that you have to transfer an existing Windows boot disk to a new motherboard, and you have to reactivate that, and there might be some problems with it. Well, apparently we have some kind of religious thing over here, some kind of chapel here in the woods, and that's that little building I was referring to. So supposedly this is like some kind of a very little church sort of building. Apparently this thing is quite old, over 100 years old, according to this, built in 1913. So this thing is old. But there's also something up there, like some other little chapel thing. Oh, somebody wrote stuff in the tree. But the thing is with Windows, is there's a difference between the BIOS and the UEFI firmware in terms of boot mechanisms. On my old PC, it was set to legacy mode, which means it uses the MBR booting scheme instead of GPT, which is like the new one that UEFI firmwares use. And these things kind of have to match. If they don't match, your system won't boot off that particular drive. Luckily, recent mainboards still support the legacy boot method. So I hope that should be fine, and Windows 10 should be intelligent enough to install motherboard drivers that it detects something different. Oh, this is apparently that thing, but that's the old one, and this is like a replica. The original one was demolished in the 1970s, according to that sign. Oh yeah, 2008 is this one built. So it's about 10 years old, and it's really just a replica of an older one that existed here. But yeah, just take that into account if you're trying to transfer an existing Windows installation to a new motherboard with Windows 10. That should go a lot easier, as Windows will automatically look for changes in the hardware configuration on boot up, and so it might find the correct drivers. But of course, we just have to knock on wood for that one. I just hope that's going to work smoothly, But if not, I will have to reinstall Windows. Be a bit of a bummer, because it would cost, of course, a lot of additional time. I mean, I have to reinstall all the applications, all the settings. That's always a real dread when you're setting up a new PC. And well, I just read in a magazine that nowadays you could, like, simply use a new motherboard, and Windows 10 should then be able to boot from it, as long as the boot mechanisms and the partition schemes are the same. Apparently the UEFI firmware has a different way of setting up partitions than the old BIOS mode. In the past it was always the master boot record scheme, but that is kind of going to be a thing of the past. But at this point it's still supported by most mainboards, as it's part of the UEFI standard. But yeah, that's something you have to take into account. And of course, you also have to think about 32-bit and 64-bit versions, but I've already used a 64-bit version anyway, so I don't expect there to be any problem. But yeah, this little forest basically has a hill here, and yeah, some kind of chapel. Anyway, this vacation I'm also planning on going to the railway museum in Utrecht. There's even a train going from the central station to the museum, but that one only goes once per hour. And well, in terms of walking distance, it's about 2 kilometers from the station to the museum. And I didn't want to do that on a particularly hot day, so I might be considering doing that next week. Well, and when that PC of mine is ready and set up and working, I might be getting into those 5 1/4 inch drives. That's why I'm going to those thrift stores, just hoping to find one, because these things are just really expensive if you look for them on eBay and on specialist websites. Yeah, they're just hard to find. There's apparently some kind of field and even a road in the distance there. But yeah, doesn't look like we can easily get there. But in this area you've got a lot of forests and castles and country estates and the like. Especially in the Fordland area, it's, well, castles everywhere. Well, I use the term castle loosely. They're more like country houses, more or less, and with large estates, not really old castles. Don't expect anything like medieval buildings with big fortifications. No, not that kind of castles, but more like country estates with large houses that are very old, but yeah, they're not really a proper castle in my opinion. And there's a telecoms tower just here at the edge of the field. Well, I can't get there. It's yeah, not accessible from here, and I don't want to go into these bushes. Yeah, can't be bothered, it's just a telecoms tower. I mean, yeah, there are easier places to look for those. I mean, just go to your nearest, well, urban area and you might be able to find one. Oh, hey, wait a minute, here is a little pot. Let's go in it. Let's go in it. Well, there's the telecoms tower. Let's see what we got here. This one is from T-Mobile. The purple or pink sticker says property of T-Mobile, protected by SDNA code. And there's a lot of equipment there from Ericsson. Oh, telecoms equipment. There's some equipment from KPN. And of course this is the tower with all the transmitters. So that will make your mobile phone work. I wonder what's in those. Maybe they are voltage converters, I have no idea, but there is a lot of cabling going up that tower, and even this here is like a cable tray thing. And those things over there as well. But yeah. Those things that you saw there, you could find them pretty much everywhere. In fact, these sort of rural areas usually have really bad phone coverage, especially in the border region, in the area of Brekelenkamp, which is in Noordoost Twente, and at the area of Denenkamp and the German town Nordhorn, just in that sort of border edge, they've got really poor mobile phone coverage. And that's because they are just a border region. Hey, let's go here. I wonder what this is. I think this is actually going into that town called Barchem, by the looks of it. And if you look at that house, it looks like they've demolished a side extension part of the building. You can see where the roof used to be, and there's a white piece on the wall about there. So they removed something of that house. Yeah. Well, this is the town. And here we got Mr. Squirrel. So let's get back into these woods, because I of course want to go back to the parking lot and to the car and go home. But yeah, this is just a kind of small little forest that has a snack bar that you can eat, and it was actually quite good and not too expensive. So I will remember this for the next time, because this looks like it could potentially have more. But anyway, when my PC is completed, it will have a gigabyte H370 DH3 mainboard. It will have the Core i5-9600K processor. That is technically the overclock version, but I'm not going to overclock it. I'm just going to let it run at the stock speed, because I think it's already a lot faster than my current system. Yeah, there's even more stuff here in those trees. I wonder what this could be. I haven't got a clue, but something about the outer shell of that tree looks a little bit damaged. Well, so that was it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for watching.